How you guys doing today? I am ready to play the motherfucking Wcoop main event. $5,200. Here's the glorious, the main event. The main event of the world championship. We took down that pot on 2K, it's great. Looks like a fantastic table. We're gonna look everybody up though. Man, I'm super excited. So BBZ, wow, this looks incredible. I've been on much worse, but let's look up the rest, you never know. Sometimes it's like some old school fucking legend that comes back for a little party. Obviously, we didn't know a single person in the MTT world from any stage. Except for like 12 years ago when I actually used to play them. Tikoi. Tikoi. Premier. Those are the guy that I know. The 5k main. What a flop, holy shit. Yeah, we're gonna call like whatever, two big blinds, nines, pretty cheap. Gonna check raise this in the main. We will be check raising this flop quite a bit, and now we have an actual fucking monster. So why not? Because it is nothing yet. So it's still like to take it down. We do. Got ace jack in the main, and jack 10 in the other main. Today's my actual birthday, win today two or something in my honor, please. Nice, Drazak. Congratulations, hope you have a swell day. Alright. Take it, take it. Ooh. Alright, see, now we busted the fucking double deuce and we're entering. Alright, it's 5k. Oh! Yeah, dude. The music that we play.
Main event takedown less than three.
Yo, IB Thunder with the 3,000 bits. Thank you so much, my guy. Oh my god, thank you. Thank you very much. So we got King Queen. Three way, interesting. If he bets, I'm gonna call again. He can still barrel spade draws, he can have King Jack. Like right now, I'm gonna assume that we have the best hand a lot. I don't put anybody on a deuce. This guy could have nines or deuces, but no kings. Probably not ace king, but let's be real, people could flat ace king. Somebody said he wasn't a fun player, so I don't know what's up with that, but. So I did an interview once at the World Series, and I'm standing there, and they're asking me, like, for poker news or something. They're asking me, how's it going? I was like, well, I lost a big pot to somebody, but he 3-bet me quite a bit that day. And he walks by and he just tells me 3%. And I was like, in the interview. So he just literally said the 3-bet percentage of that guy. So in the interview, I was like, so I lost a big pot because I made a big mistake. So that was really funny. The guy's just a fucking computer brain. So yeah, that guy's brain is a HUD. Not mine though. All right, slowly winning some chips. This is also pretty cool. Fucking amazing flop here for Queen 9. Alright, we're just gonna bet he has way more Queen X than Jack 10. We can always reconsider if he raises the river, but most of the time I'm just gonna get called by Ace King or King Queen. Possibly Queen Jack, Queen 10, depends how much of a hero he feels like today. Nice. Fucking nice, yeah. Over 300k now. It's a good start of the main. Gonna call here. This is the 5k, guys. Massive event. We had a good start. We started with 250k. We are on 150, 165 big blinds. Great stuff. Hope we don't need to re-enter or anything. 1128 people out in now. Hotter. The hotter. How do you fucking say that? The hotter? Don't people just say hotter? That's the hotter. Nobody says hotter. What the fuck, man? De Niro, great voice actor confirmed. You know it. You know it. Alright, C-betting is a fun player in a $5,000 tournament on a board where I don't think he's gonna peel without hits, and I have no showdown value. But the jack on the river makes everything okay. Alright, so we're gonna bet that pretty strongly. 18k. This is what I mean, like, this is kind of the kind of play that I'll use in these events. These are really good moves to make in big events, big fields. And that's really why you have to alter within like a 10k or something like that. Because if you do this in a 10k, with like a 10k non-main event with a lot of good players in it, 18k, 64. Good luck with your fucking ace king. You know, that's what they do. And we got kings in the 5k, that's true. So let's go over to the kings. Yadubski, thank you for the sub. Why do you care about losing? I don't understand. Why do you care about losing thousands and thousands of dollars? Why do you stress? I'm gonna bet, check, call, I think, here. I wonder if he would turn hands into bluffs, though. That's the question. Maybe this is not the kind of board for it. A blocking jack straight draw, so it's hard to put. Like, I'm just thinking about what is the worst river here? An ace or a jack, right? So I'm thinking about what's worst case scenario on the river and what would my line be. If it's an ace, I'm definitely check folding. If it's a jack, then I think, alright, what would he turn into a bluff? Jack 9 and King Jack. But I blocked King Jack and he's not gonna defend Jack 9 all that often against me. So that would be kind of a tough spot. So if I don't really have a lot of hands I wanna check call against. Maybe I should bet. Great stack though. Gonna take a three-way flop here. Lead at it. I don't think that this board is gonna be c-bet too much. It's gonna be c-bet a little bit more than a board like 3-6-4, 8-6-3, you know, or 8-5-4 or 8-5-3. It's a little bit different. People are a little bit more afraid of straight rows there. All right, here's queen in the main. Let's see what happens. Kind of 4-bet. 3-bet, I'm sorry. The nice thing is that it's a board where I can bet a lot of bluffs as well. I can double barrel hands like Queen 10, King 10, King Queen, which are all well in my 3-bet range. Which means I can go for a lighter bit of value too, which is nice. So raising Queen Jack, especially in a big field like this, with so many fun players at the table, I would raise hands like Queen Jack. Check out a new card. That's the one. That's the blackout I mentioned. Yeah. We just lost the 3 deuce high all in on the flop in the 27 hyper. And that's a boat. So let's hope that he has something disgustingly good here. I want to send somebody home with the thought, oh my god, I played against fucking Lex and he made a boat and it hit my straight. And you know, I want a story like that. That's what I like. Dominator. Hey, Scoop Yop, give to the sub to Bernie Red. We have 10s in the main. We're gonna shove the 9s. Let's first see this beautiful 10 high flop here. Payouts of the 5k, that's no real points, they're not over the guarantee yet, so it doesn't say much. I like that flop here, please. Okay. Let's play this one then. Great flop. Alright, that's always good. Get rid of pre-flop raiser. So now, I don't think that this guy with this stack is going to slow the aces and kings. So then we have such a much more comfortable feeling. If they give a lot of action, they might, you know, still have a draw, but... like, tell me that this guy is not just going to bet a spade draw small when preflop raises checks and there's one guy on this board, you know? So I would be pretty scared there of a lot of action, but...
I'm a dominator.
Jesus Christ, won't cut us sick.
Subbing hey, to Merv's channel in advance. Fuck you.
Haha! Uppy, thank you for the 28 months, man. Tier 2. Fucking wonderful, dude. Really appreciate it. Alright, so... this is what we want to do in 5k main events. I don't give a shit if he 4-bets or whatever. I really like that I play this way in these big events. Preparation, confidence, reflection on strategy. I did a coaching session before Wcoop, after Wcoop, and before Wcoop. It's a pretty reasonable flop for us, actually. He's not going to fold many pairs, that's for sure, but... what he is going to fold is his king queens, his queen jack suited. I'm going to put a little bit of extra spice on there. Just so that he... I don't want to barrel more than once. Well, that's actually not true. I do want to barrel more than once in case it's a... Broadway card. Too bad, I don't think he's folding. Whoa, holy shit. We block ace king, ace queen, and aces. Ace Jack's most likely folding to this sizing and this 3-bet. And even if they flat, we're both gonna miss the flop a lot. And when we do, I'm gonna take the pot, you know? Big ass Ben, thank you for the sub. Much appreciated, Oppy, much appreciated. Oh, 55 hyper. I can just register that right now because they don't have re-entries. Alright, alright. We're gonna have to check this. There's no fucking way we're gonna get called by anything worse. With Jack 8 is out there? I don't think so. If we bet a really small, 9x might come around, but what are we gonna do then? Check the turn? And then if he does have... if we bet small and they do have flush draws or straight draws, they have easy pickings on the river? I don't know. It's much better to just check and go into bluff catching mode. People who hate Daniel tend to be Doug's derpy fans and shout more eggs better because Doug told him to. That's kind of true too. Like, a big part of like what you see on Twitter is because of that. Which is what I don't like about... Doug's social presence, you know, like Doug creates more toxicity than he does like motivation or helping people to look forward and what's best and whatever. He's kind of keeping people in a mindset, which as a poker fan I don't like, and as a content creator I don't like either. I really hope that Joey can kind of break away from that in a way, you know. I feel like he really sucks in Joey too with that. I think that's, yeah, I guess that's the best way to say it. I'm supposed to have Wcoop 22, 1 million, had Jax vs Ace Jack. I'm sorry, DJ Iggs. I'm sorry, mate. Sorry that had to happen to you, buddy. What the fuck?
I'm a Dominator.
Is this? What the fuck is this? I'm so... baffled by this. Okay, let's think about bluffs, right? If you want to make a bluff, why not just 40,000? What does 40,000 not achieve that overbetting all in does? When a pot that goes bet call check check. All right, we're gonna defend this. This isn't a $5,000 main event. Remember, guys, purple felt is main event. Pretty big bets, but it could also be... that's so bad. There's so many bluffing hands that have queen. It's a big bet, but a lot of times a big bet can also mean, hey, I want to try this once and then I'm done. Man, really need to like aim to get called by queen X here. Alright, big pot though. Nice little blind defend worked out for us. And we have aces. We're gonna 3-bet Igor Karkarov, the best player we had at our table pretty much the whole event here. So far, of course. Go for some cheeky A6 bluff bet, 3-bets here, so don't necessarily rep nothing. I mean, doesn't get more beautiful than this flop. Do you have any idle? Arnold Schwarzenegger. Old Fepperhand LOL, thank you for subbing. Says the 5k. I'll do it short.
Do you hear it? It's coming. Now Lex, take us home.
I hope so, dude. I hope so, Avi. Thank you so much, man. Thank you for the $10. Yes! Yes, 500k in the main. And this is looking pretty good, this table. We're 181st out of 1200. Total of 1661 people registered. Lexus run good. Subscribe with a tier 2 sub. Oh, you upgraded your sub as well. So you subbed, you donated, and now you upgraded your sub. I like this. I like it. But in my position, I can win more by playing hands. This is one of those spots where you just hope that they check the flop back, and as soon as they do, you're going to win the pot a whole lot. Can't fault somebody though for doing that shit. Everybody does it too. Of course, there's also like the everybody does it. The same with seeding scripts, you know. I really don't agree with that. It's very predatory for the game. Never used one. Alright, nice. Always nice to take small pots like that. What do you prefer, donor or gifted subs for the same amount? Gifted subs, because they grow the community. It's also cool because, like, people who normally couldn't sub or something, they see what Discord is like, or they see what it's like chatting during sub mode, or using emotes, all that stuff, you know? It gives people kind of a taste of it. So it's good. I like that. It's a good thought. But we're your friends. You're right. And Ace King got called. Alright, let's go back to this one because Ace King is not that interesting now. This is also in the 5k. Damn it. God damn it. God damn fuck! Ace 5 raising in the main event. See about this board in the main. Great boards. I think we're gonna get some credit if we bet this against the big blinds. Can we just hit a fucking heart? Thank you very much. There's King 9, Ace 9, Ace 8, King 8. 8 7s. I think we have an Ace high. We have like as bad as we normally have here. Definitely need to bet. Yeah, dude. Come on, folks.
Good luck today, Lex.
Oh, thank you so much, El Yungo. Thank you for the $10. That is nice of you. Oh, that's so fucking sweet, dude.
Hopefully we can bring them back for the new army joiners. You're an inspiration for everyone.
Sid, that's such a nice message, dude. Let me get back to that real quick. This is fucking insane. This is a 5k main event. Already massive pot. Oh my god, we have 900k. Yes! Oh yes, oh my god, that is so fucking nice. Oh! Oh, that feels so fucking good. That feels so fucking good. We have more than 100 big blinds. Full double up in the main event. Oh my god, it's so nice. Against a tough opponent too. Defended the big blind in the main. Flop top trips. Jesus. Okay. Okay, okay. We flop a set of sixes in the main event of the Wcoop. I'm just gonna check raise this. I would check raise quite a bit here. Not a whole lot, you know, but enough to really check raise strong value hands too. It's also like the kind of board where if there's certain turns, it's gonna be very hard for me to like check raise all in, or you know, once he bet at a certain stage. I'm gonna shove this. Please, no nasty shit. Man, that would really put our feedback on the ground.
I think saving the run good for the mains is winning poker strategy. Good job on that one, Lex.
Oh man. Alright, 1.5 million. We're second. We're second in the main event. We're second in the fucking main event. 1.5 million. Alright, guys. We're gonna raise. Bustoville. Incredible PLO player. Really, really respect him. Thought he was one of the tougher regs I played against, honestly. So that means that he's gonna be pretty smart. Pretty good with bet sizings. So pretty apt read. Have you eaten yet? You better be taking care of yourself. Yes. Thank you, Chrissy. That's not misclick either. That's not bet 120k or something. You know. Let's not do any of the stupid stuff. Alright. Let's not do any of the stupid stuff. Yo, funk you. So this is when we bet the turn against Jack X. Some king highs. Maybe some queen tens. You know. And then we check the river.
Let's go.
It's fucking crazy. Let's go, let's go. Digo Sirius SRS. Thank you so much for the sub as well. Oh my god, Lexus Run Good. There you go. That's it. Lexus Run Good had subscribed. Lexus Run Good donated. Lexus Run Good got involved.
Hi there. Let's go.
I'm gonna call ones. Yo, thank you so much, LSQ1710, for the 25 fucking subs. It's fucking crazy. It's a pretty light call on the turn, but my bet sizing was so fucking small.
Run for the royal and fuck you.
Run for the royal. Oh my god, Scott! Holy shit, dude. Thank you, Scott Goodall. Thank you for the 10 bucks. Run for the royal. We're up against the... almost 50 big blind stack. The standard is to flat with jacks there. Alright, this is gonna suck because I put my alarm wrong apparently. I don't know what went wrong there, but... I don't wanna register the big 215 now, because then we're just gonna end up in rebuy hell. And I don't like that place. 2 minutes though. Yeah, damn, are you fucking right? We have chips. Alright, easy, easy value bet now. Raising jack 9 in the main. Table got very tough, by the way. This is an insanely tough table. It's about as tough as they come, honestly. Alright. Even some hands that he's going to use as bluffs are going to dominate my jack a lot. Jack 9 is not the hand you want to defend 3-bets with in these positions. If it's like there, then it's much better, but not in these two. Damn, it's too bad. Like, we missed in like 3 3-bet spots. Win a 3-bet here in the main, in the 5k. Sasko watch Sasko who? Thank you so much for the continuing the sub gift you got. Good flop for us. Check one. We're not gonna get three streets against Queen X anyway. So knowing that, normally we can get value from weaker kings as well, right? King Jack, King 10. That's not possible now either. So I think that also to balance that we don't always check queens or weaker or something. It's really good to just check King 9 here. It's not an ideal river, but we gotta bet it anyway. Betting is much better than checking here. Because there's definitely still hands that he can call us with that we beat. And if he bets something like this, we're going to call anyway. So it's going to be pretty tough to raise, to bluff raise there, right? Over us on the river. All right, we got queens. Call behind us. So he has 50 something big blinds. This is gonna go in, obviously. This guy is 40 bigs. This is gonna go in. We're gonna go in with queens here. We have the third best hand in poker, you know. We get 3-bet by it. We get squeezed by a reg, so. There you go. That stings a little bit. Jesus Christ. That puts us in fourth again. Ace is in the big blind now. Alright, let's do this thing the other way around. Let's do this thing the other way around. By now he's gonna have probably seen on the stream that we 3-bet him with King 9, so that's gonna do a lot for us.
So many uplifting messages. I thought I was watching an Oprah and Dr. Phil crossover show on Twitch. I have a cup of concrete for you to harden the fuck up. Also, fuck you. Less than fucking three. Win one of these motherfucking things, damn it.
Thank you so much, Kiwi Sean, for the $3. OG troll don't know where. That's too bad. Fuck, what an expensive flip. Fuck. What an expensive flip. I got enough concrete in my fucking spine, dude. Don't worry about it. I got enough fucking concrete. I'm gonna raise this small to big blind. Really strong hand. If we get 3-bet, we can call. If he flats, tasty flop. Come on, put a fucking heart now. Don't let it all go to shit, please. And it's like impossible to triple barrel this board too. Like even an 8 has the fucking easiest hero call in the world here. Fuck! God damn it. It's annoying. Yeah, equity in this hand is fucking unreal. I'm gonna raise in the main. Crazy spot. 30 big blinds. Keep it, man. Big blinds. Big blind fucking 3-bet. Queen jack suited. No fucking thank you. Keep it. We also got 3-bet in the main. Fucking main event. We got 3-bet. Gotta be very careful here. I'm gonna, this is super exploitable. I'm gonna fold. Fuck it. I like everything's tingling. Crazy only best spot there. It's super weird to me because what you do, there's one thing you know, right? Okay, let's listen to this. Listen to this because I understand that it might seem weird. So there's one thing here that you know. He doesn't do it with ace 8, right? He's not gonna do this with any of his bluff hands. Right? We can agree about that, right? There's no... The bluff part of his range, that is nothing. Sevens, eights, anything. Ace five, anything. So, at the very minimum, I'm gonna be up against ace jack. Ace king, honestly, I think is unlikely. I truly think it's unlikely that he does it with ace king. So it's like, ace jack, hearts, jacks, tens, nines, possibly queens, but aces and kings. I just don't think I'd do too hot against that range. Plus, I don't like the way that felt that pot. So, I'm not saying that like as a field player or some shit, but just like from a strategy perspective, I think he was trying to do something clowny, but I think it was just strength. Oh my god, great turn here. So 25 big blinds behind in the main event. Yeah, this guy typed a heart in the chat as soon as the rage was streamed, so I don't know what that is about, but it actually makes me... It doesn't have to mean something bad, but if he doesn't mean it bad, he's a giant cunt. If you win a pot like that in a tournament like that and you're gonna trash talk even though you don't know somebody at all, that's... Okay, okay, it's gonna be a little bit harder to get called now because we're trying to target King X.
I'm a Terminator.
But, I mean, great turn regardless, right?
Thank you for the ongoing entertainment. Looking forward to Tuesday. Take it all down.
Nice. Oh my god, what a setup. What a fucking setup. But we're back over 2 million. Fuck it. I'll take all my setups now. Over 50 bigs. Thank you so much, Hikateya. Alright. I bet the flop one big blind. I pretty much want to get value from Queen Highs. I think that Queen Highs, Jack Highs, he's calling on the flop. Yeah. Got ace king in the main. Jesus Christ, that ace jack hand though. Holy fuck. That ace jack hand. It's kind of crazy. T700 subs, holy shit. Nice. Alright. Let's read about this. We're gonna 3-bet, and if Troll Pro ends up shoving, we're gonna call here. This is a $5,000 main event, guys. Damn, 600 people left. $250 people cash. Crazy. Here we go. Fred's on 88. Thank you for subbing. If there's ever like a spot that we 4-bet bluff from, it would be this one. Like a regular 3-betting a fun player, all deep stacks. Felix Lacobus, thank you for subbing. Alright, win a lot of chips.
I'm a Terminator.
Not worried. It's 5K is absolutely yours. Thank you, Father of Awesome. Thank you for your message today, that was nice.
I'm a Terminator.
I look up. Yeah, and I take my time, nigga. I'ma take my time, Walt.
I'm a Terminator.
Mm-hmm. Power moves only, nigga.
I'm a Terminator.
Boy, I'm about my business on business. I drink liquor. This is usually like a call the side spot. It's not gonna go anywhere before the river. And then on the river, you have to guess to yourself to think, like, how did the board change? Did he get any two pairs? You know, they're not... People don't bet ace-jack 3 times on a board like this, never. Because then all the lower aces fold. So that's, like, exactly the cutoff of betting. Obviously, it's very unlikely to have ace-queen. So then you need to wonder, are they bluffing or do they have ace-king plus? I think we can bet here. We bet small. We bet small on the turn. We bet 1/3 pot. Are you telling me this guy's gonna fold ace jack? Are you gonna tell me that he checks ace 10? If he has ace king, doesn't really matter. Because we bet so small, it doesn't really matter in the end. Even if he ends up having his king. I said fuck trying and not doing, cuz not doing is something a nigga not doing. I think he randomly is gonna turn a 10 into a bluff or something, you know, like this is the fucking main event here. Against a fun player, he's not gonna think, oh, this is small size. Actually, I don't think that my nines are good often enough. Let's just make it 400k. Like, that just doesn't happen in big fields like that. This is obviously us playing like super exploitative, which is fine. And I got me here, so I'm gonna continue trusting it. Alright, for sure, XD, thank you for continuing to soak it. Still have soundbar with all the Arnold quotes? Yes, I just haven't had any extra screens open on when my computer started crashing, and now it's not in my system, plus there's enough happening anyway. Ooh, it's a bad card. Now it's time to value bet. He's gonna check ace jack twice for sure, but like, is he really gonna check a queen twice, you know? This is the kind of board that you can definitely get hero called on, checked all the way, because he's not gonna give me too many kings. Queen is pretty unlikely. There you go. That's nice, because we lose to all the jacks as well, so this is a really good value right here. How much do you win once you get first in the main event? $1.5 million. Jacks here. Alright, blinds went up, so we have 60 bigs. Black Cell, thank you for the sub. I appreciate it, guys. Over 6,800. It's kind of nuts. You do realize that we're the first and only poker streamers to go above 3k, right? And we're at 6,800 now. Kind of nuts. kind of fucking crazy. We're gonna flat there. 4-betting is kind of turning my hand into a bluff. That'll be top set. Holy shit. Can we just have a stressless run out now? Like not the 10 of hearts on the turn or something?
I'm a Terminator.
10 Ben, 82, thank you for the sub. So far so good. My heart is beating. All right, so how much do we have? I gotta give him a chance to try and rep an overpair here. Good players will do that. A fun player, I would bet big because they're gonna check some overpairs. They're gonna pot control. They're never gonna raise the river. What I need this guy to sometimes do is peel with ace king, and I need him to rep an overpair on a super safe board against an obvious value bet of jack x. Or even shove for value with ace king, ace queen. All that is possible if I bet small. If he flats here with queen, so be it. But this is the way we can get paid for all of it. And it's a perfect balance play too. Because he expects us to do this with like 10s or ace jack or king jack, you know. Alright, that's a big pot though. 2.5 million!
I'm a Terminator.
Oh my god, meets Jesus, thank you so much man for the sub gift.
I'm a Terminator.
Somebody 3-bets, I'm gonna shove. Like if this guy squeezes, I'm gonna shove. How you doing, what's up Rick? I'm not doing alright Jake, it's tense, but I'm doing fine. Yeah, peppers on farm, thank you dude.
Terminator.
The mentor, thank you for the sub.
I'm a Terminator.
Sausage King also with the sub, thank you. See you later, B-Fan. Nice score on DraftKings again, buddy. Oh my god, we made it. Oh my god, Monte Carlo, you gave so many subs last time too, you gave a $250 dono. Guys, thank you all though, thank you all, we passed 7,000 fucking subs, we have more than 7,000 subs. Like, I have no words for this, I remember, I watched Twitch for so long, and I remember watching all these streamers, oh my god, we gotta sway for that. I was watching all these streamers, and sometimes 5,000 subs, 6,000 subs, I'd be like, wow, these guys are amazing, whatever, and... Monte Carlo, dude, thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. 7k subs. This is a day to never forget. Ah, shit. 7,018 subs. That's right. We did it, Reddit. Everybody up your speed. That was a couple of years ago. Again, if he opens with a very easy fold. Nine spots away. It's also really nice for us that he's out of position. This hand, he's in the worst position to play with us. And he's the only stack that covers us. Oh wait, he too, but he's been playing pretty tight. Even though he peeled with fives, which is kind of weird. We have so much fold equity in this spot. This guy has so much to lose. Legitimately, he's in spot 224. 224 with 8 spots from the money, so very unlikely. We keep on 2.5 mil, so we find our raising spots too. We're just not overdoing it or raising a whole lot. Getting closer. All these guys have less than 10 blinds. Oh, hello. 5 spots away.
I'm a Terminator.
Yo, Claudius, 91 TM. Thank you for subbing. Man, a 9 would be great. Nice little pot. Jack 7 offsuit. Oh my days. Look at you fucking go. I respect that. Sense fucking poker. Like 10 big blinds and that would be so stressful. Yeah, it's unbelievable how tight you'd have to play. It's kind of crazy. Ooh. This guy busted me out of the 2K, or the 500 day two, right? I got 13th or something, 12th, when I shoved King 9 for 22 big blinds on the button. King 9 of diamonds. Got 10s. I'm gonna flat it. It was a really strong opening range, but I mean, I could flop insanely strong, right? Flop a set. If he has ace king or ace queen, he's not gonna barrel me much. He's not gonna put like triple barrels in with ace king in this situation, right? Could consider 3-bet folding too, by the way. But I actually like this a little bit better. 3 spots off an 11. $11,000 cash.
Good to see you're chipping up here, Lex. Stressful to watch. I'm quite ugly, but I don't have to charge my phone all the time. Fuck you.
What a fucking check. Oh my god, what a check. I knew it. Lost the fucking bare minimum there, holy shit. Alright, nice. We lost 5 big blinds, 10s versus jacks. A-okay. Yeah, so these last few guys are just gonna go all the way down to Drizzy. And they should. It's gonna be a matter of like who gets the big blind first, but you know, like I said, these guys are gonna have shoving spots as well. Let's see what happens. I don't know, there's a redraw tomorrow, so we're on the exact bubble now. Tournament split hand for hand. Taylor S live. Taylor Swift live. It's continuing to give the sub to God from Monte Carlo. That's nice. Ooh. This is a great spot to shove. I love the way this guy plays. How did 2k go? We got 40th again in the high roller, 6700. Lost Kings vs Ace King and Ace King vs Ace 10. Super frustrating, but still decent score, right? But all these 40th places don't do shit for us. 40th places result in a minus 70k Wcoop, so. Whoa, he called with Ace 10. Dude, holy shit. No fucks given, alright. Yeah, no fucks given, guys. Just gonna fucking call with Ace 10. Even though there's a guy, I mean, there's no way, right? This fucking guy got fucked pretty hard. Just gonna call with Ace 10. Even though there's guys with one end, with one small blind out there. This guy's one small blind. That to me is surreal, but it's okay. Oh, crocodile's all in on his big blinds. I throw on my leather jacket, a collection of biker patches. One of them says savage, the other one black savage. There's really no need to tank me anymore. Barely any skin left. Whiskey pin after 12. I'm always playing with death. Bullet shields in my. It's been one of my favorite streams. I'm really glad, Mobilis. It had everything today, man. Sub records. A lot of people in here. Everything. Fucking drama. Big money tournaments. We bubbled the tournament. We cashed one for 6k. We're watching a fucking 11k bubble right now. That's not a brick. Probably good for us. Alright, that's it. That's it. Let's see who bubbles. So, Crocodile's out. Crocodile's out, but if this guy's not gonna bubble, wow, this guy's actually gonna make it, isn't he? Because this guy folded, so. And nobody had. Oh! This guy's out too. Man, it's gonna be a shit show tomorrow from the start. These guys are all in now for the last part. Alright, so Ericora just bust two guys, so these guys bust. So there's two more guys out. And this guy with 4k gets in the money. Are you able to pronounce people's screen names correctly so quickly? I just see screen names quickly. I don't know, maybe because I game so much online. Man, I gave him some props, like, well played, brutal dude, like, Jesus.
I'm a Terminator.
Snowman Taters, that fucking Ace 10 call too, like, what the fuck is going on, you know? Man, what a tournament, we got it though. Players are on break, we're no longer hand for hands. We are in the fucking money, we resume tomorrow. That's in 13 hours, this actually looks nice, it's in 13 hours, that makes that we have a lot of sleep. Alright, so let's look at the damage here. Crocodile with the absolute bubble. This guy was playing really well. So two guys from our table bust. Chris makes it. He makes it. Oh my god. Too bad. Alright, so let's go over the fucking people that are in. Holy shit. What a fucking stream. Alright, let's go top to bottom. We got our chip leader across 10 million chips. Let's see what the level is going to be like. I think we're gonna have 30 big blinds tomorrow. This bubble was unreal for everybody. I mean, the tournament clock doesn't stop, right? So we play like what? 10 hands a level, maybe? So the blinds went up a lot, but we're still in 94th out of 248. Like I said, it's gonna be a sick bubble. So we have Linus Love, best No Limit Hold'em Cash Game player currently. There is. And he's won the 25k high roller on Friday or Saturday, whatever it was. Pretty fucking sick. Malacca style, good aggressive regular. Koenigsgebouw, I always seen the high rollers. Don't know too much. Of course, like, I'm not some known person about all the regulars, but I'll just say why. No. Naza won the 5k Turby Bounty Builder. Compris is a very good PLO, PLO Hold'em regular from Sweden. Black 88 always seems to go deep in any of these. Never Scared Beat is Ben Wokanowski. He's really good at PLO, also really good at Hold'em tournaments. Ben CB is Ben CB, fucking legend. What the fuck? Ben CB legend. Noah Buchan from Holland still in 2, 4 million. Awesome spot for him. Pisanio, obviously you guys know that guy. Eric, I think he's a sub, but good to see him there. Sin Karma, awesome. Jort van Hove, so lots of Dutch people still in, or some big names. Kimo, Orb the Turk, we played with him earlier. Kimo Kha, crazy PLO, kind of like fun player reg. Eric Cora, just amazing at PLO and Hold'em. Full Machi, sick. River Sosa, that A-10 call is just disgusting, disgusting. Lasagna Man, that's Mustafa Kanit, of course. I am best two good player. Antin is really good. Krafttackle, amazing player. München is still on regular. Vroom, obviously. He's insane. He's one of like top 5 PLO players in the world or something. Time to crush it. Oh my god, you turned him around. 4, 3, 2, 1. Thank you, I, Alex.
Time to crush it on day 2.
Thank you so much, man. Thank you so much. Huge dono, dude. Thank you guys so much for everything today. Hopmark, crazy. Also from Lebanon. There's some crazy fucking guys from Lebanon. It's nuts. That's Mikita Batjakowski. Ravenswood, Dutch guy. Insane, insane poker mind. Really respect that guy. Giraffe Ganger, one of the sickest, of course. C. Darwin is still in. Lange is also really sick. Dynalot, guy from Canada, really nice PLO player, Hold'em player. JC Alvarado, a bit too easy, one of the best cash game regulars there is. Marco Vitz's tournament beast. Matthias de Mulder, also still in with a lot more than his twin brother. Pipi Tapip in the Huda, also still in. Bedio's good, Hope is a good player. So see, this is Andreas Mateos, so that's this. That's him, not the other guy, Amadi 13 at our table, that crazy 10s guy. New guy, isn't that Paul Nui? I'm not sure, I think it's Paul Nui, but I'm not sure. Liv Ree is still in. Dmitry Ivanovich already won an event today. Anib Masari, crazy good regular. Good regular. Connor's still in. Probeers, Tournament Legends, also really good at cash games. Ape Styles, Legends. Ringelsdorf, really tough, cool is good. Buck 21 is Sean Buchanan. I Am Sound, also is one of the No Limit GG guys. Wizzo Wizzo, Oli Shamion, Mitz, Tournament Regular. And Chris Altemilder got in, so that's all. That's all. Everybody, good morning, good to see you. Oh my god, what a day it's gonna be. It's the World Championship of Online Poker. We're at the finale. Doesn't get more final than this. I am super excited. Let's immediately just jump into it and let's look at what we're actually playing for. You guys are fucking showing up in full force. It's unbelievable. Thank you so much for that. So yesterday we passed 7,000 subs. Huge shout out to you guys. Incredible.
Good luck today, Lex.
Thank you so much, King Taz. So we're playing for 1.5 million. The main cash has already passed. It's 11,200 now. Today's going to be insane. It's really good that you guys show up from the start. Because the next money jump is going to be $3,000. That's just a money jump. $3,000 and then $3,000, $5,000, $6,000. So these money jumps are insane. And why it's especially insane today is because... So we're here in 94th. So 197 make the 3K money jump. Let's go check out, see how Mr. 197 is doing. He has 8.5 big blinds. That means that all these guys have less than him. And they need to bust before we have a 3K jump. So there's definitely pretty serious ICM implications. Right off the bat, it's going to be a madhouse. Even looking at the table we're on, this guy has 10 big blinds. The rest of them are pretty deep. This guy won a huge, like one of probably the most insane pot I've seen. He went all in on the turn with a 2-outer in the crazy spot on the exact fucking bubble. And he got there. Crazy, crazy. I'm excited. And off we go. All right, so Andrea Mateos, Joris Hoof, the cleaner, Mustafa Kanit, Ape Styles, Kurt WCP. All right, so if you're gonna play the World Championships, if anything, might as well get this table, right? Might as well get this table. What a table this is. Like I said, the first 15 casualties, first 15 people are out. This is why I was talking about that 197, that's such a crazy spot. And we have to be careful too, because when we race, people like this can really put pressurize a lot, you know. We can't really take shit from these two guys. We have to take a lot of shit from these two guys as well, because we're definitely one of those stacks that is in danger of not making it. Wow, that's so cool. That's so complete. Thank you so much for the sub, man. Alright, we got aces. This guy, oh no, we're too deep. Alright, so the interesting part is, what do we do now? Do we limp or do we shove? I think we shove so much. I think we shove so often that we should shove aces. Because Kurt is a regular, right? Like, Kurt knows, listen, there might be a money bump in 20 spots, but I got fucking King 10 and I can't fold this. I think that shoving is better here, even though it's on a bubble. Because he's short enough, right? He has 8 or 9 big blinds behind. It's too bad nobody fucking raised. He could put a lot of pressure on me too, so that's too bad. I think that the tournament will definitely kind of break open the moment that we reach... the 197 money bubble. Like, I really feel like this is where everybody's not gonna look at the money anymore, right? Unless you then get to this point again. 152 will be like 3k more again, but like, this is the most important bubble because it's so easy to make it with all these shorties out there. Alright, so if somebody raises, we fold. Very easy. If everybody folds, we raise. Very easy decision here. It's also like, you have to think about it this way, right? Like, what is a situation that's normally good with sixes? Is if you check it down against good ace highs. When people are like, I might win on this board, and you check it down and you get the showdown. What is the problem when you're near a big money bubble? Is that this guy, who's really good, Mustafa Kanit, right? Super accomplished player. He might think, you know what, fuck you guys. And this guy might also think, you know what, I have a bigger stack than you. I'm going to fire a few bullets, see if we can get you to fold. So people barrel way more when they have the bigger stack, which also means that, you know, the value of my sixes goes down. Because there's no, like, as much showdown value. Yo, thanks so much, man. RDL, thank you. Alright, this is it, guys. So, money bubbles are money bubbles. Even though we're 10 spots away, we are not gonna walk away from a big hand. Yo, thank you so much, buddy. Thank you for the 5, man. Thank you. So if we get 3-bet, the money's gonna sail in. No problem. We're gonna get pressurized more often. And we just gotta hope that we're not up against something big, right? We just gotta hope that we're not up against something big. Yeah! Alright, that feels pretty fucking good. I'm not gonna lie. Oh, really? Does it feel good? Yeah, it feels kind of good. Oh, why wouldn't you say? Yeah, no, I know. I just didn't, you know. Yeah, of course that feels fucking good. Oh my god. All right. All right. 60 bigs. Whew. It's 27 now. What a flip. What a flip. What a flip. The implications are crazy there. Very interesting. Especially under the gun spot. So we're on the exact bubble now. I was just kind of thinking, like, well, how I would do against this shoving range. Because I think we can discount, like, Jack 10 suited and stuff from that, you know, with a 3k bubble at the next person with somebody with two big blinds. Gotta treat it as a bubble. Don't really think that guy shows light. But then again, he only has 7 bigs, so. Clawlord, thank you for the 3 months. Hakuna Shimada, thank you for the sub. Let's see, everybody playing a little bit slow. Money bubble has burst. Just now, so we're cashing 14k at least. You mad, bro? Thank you for the sub. It's kind of crazy that we have such a big stack and we're third stack at our table. That's a pretty poor flop for us. If we have the ace of clubs or something, we can continue, but. Like, think about, like, let's say he has Jack 8 of spades, right? How good that hand does against us. Plus, he gets the bluff all the scare cards and stuff, so. Stop breathing on the ace king hand. Ha! Oh, Mac, that's awesome. Hi, Creed, good to see you, man. These guys have shoving stacks for sure, but still have a good stack to open. You like. I know that these guys are shoving like solid ranges, you know, they have it figured out what they should shove, but that still means that I can open ace deuce profitably. Why is he not playing the 1k PKO? I think this is enough hype. Like, I don't want anything that happens there to affect me. Plus, I don't think the ROI in the tournament's good, because let's say I bust this, I'm gonna have such a big adrenaline dump. I'm gonna be so tired from like yesterday, the adrenaline from today, that I don't think I can play my best in a 1k. So it's just a bad decision. Jason Hume, welcome back, thank you so much. Jesus. Thank you so much, Young on Pokemon, for the 500 bits. Thank you, dude. Good to see you, buddy. On tables like this, I am gonna pick like different hands to 3-bet bluff with. So it's pretty likely that if one of these guys raised, I would just fold King Jack. Yeah, Queen 7, correct call? Yeah, easy, easy, easy. We both did what we had to do on that hand. Show the top stacks of the tournament, please. Yes, sir. So we got Linus Love now at the top. Right, we can do, I got 7-5 also. We can do a little rundown of the Malacca style, really, really good, aggressive regular. Kunings Kebab, high stakes regular. Then we have Armada 13, that's the guy who 2-outed in that 4.5 million pot on the bubble. Naza, one of the best regulars there is, won the 5k turbo bounty builder on Saturday. Comprise has been a regular PLO, no limit hold'em high stakes forever. Black 88 usually just always does good in these big events. Crazy, crazy. Exclusive, my boy from Holland. Shout out to Noah Bukan, he won the 1k horse tournament. Always takes down big events, really impressive. Has been doing that for like 15 years, even though he's not involved with poker that much anymore. Here's the winner of the tournament eventually. Ben Wokanowski, also a very accomplished tournament player. E, we talked about him on a table. Pisanio, online legend, super aggro player. All team online as well. Orbit Turk, high stakes regular. Eri Cora, both Beast in Hold'em and PLO. Absolute insane poker mind. Blue Sky, very solid. We were at the table with him yesterday. Xang, high stakes regular. And we got an all in here, Ape Styles and Lasagna Man. That's a nasty way to go out. Or to lose. Wow. Full Machi, really good regular. Matthias de Mulder, ex team pro, friend of mine, good player. Gafteko, one of the best in the business, period. Dutch guy. Hopmark, super crazy. I don't really know, man. I've been playing against him all my life. Super fucking crazy. Ben CB, of course. On his third bullet, Sin Karma. Shout out to you. Oh, shit. 1 second. Alright, Dino Law is a really good player from Canada. Cleaner, obviously, Jort van Hove, third at WCP, super accomplished. Best Dutch poker player ever, in my opinion. Makita Bacikowski, Gavs, PLO legend. Marco Witz is at our table, tournament boss, Liv Guri. The guys all know her, of course, good friend of mine. Dear Lord, Ravenswoods, possibly one of the best PLO mixed game players in the world. Insane. Dutch guy, lives in Malta. See Darwin, Connor, two of the best. Room, one of the best PLO players. Lipofant, sick. Ipsals, one of the legends in tournaments. Really nice guy. Dmitry Urbanovic. And Steve O'Dwyer is short stack right now. And Teen also very good. So that's what the listing looks like. That's a pretty nice thing to say, dude. Thank you so much for five. Kinda easy. We can just raise it. We have blockers for a lot of good stuff. Plays reasonable post-flop. It's about the weakest we'll raise, though. If it wasn't like the biggest stack or the second biggest stack and under the gun, I would definitely not raise it. So if you're new to the channel, guys, press the follow button because I stream poker a lot and I stream higher stakes. And we're also going to be playing the 25k tomorrow. So clicking the follow button will show you when I'm live, when I'm going live, all this stuff. I mean, Twitch is awesome, man, to have on next to your grind if you want to have that poker bug. Yeah, thank you so much, Mexican, for $3. Nice, nice. So we're going to check all twice and decide here. It's really good to have top pairs when you check this board sometime, because a lot of the time when you check, people are going to expect hands like ace-king, you know, ace-king, ace-queen, king-queen. You know, king-queen would probably bet, but people expect a lot of ace-highs or underpairs when you check, so it's good to have some jacks mixed in there so that you're not going to be too easy to play against. But our jack is so weak that we don't beat a lot of value bets. That's so nice, dude. Drolfin, thank you so much for the $2. That's nice of you, man. Congrats. And Barnes, thank you for the sub. So it's very easy now. We check all, check all. Very easy. And to show up a top pair here, we showed three streets of weakness, except for the check call, of course, I guess. But we show three streets of weakness, so check folding on the river would be absolute fucking madness. Would never do that. And we're up against ace queen high. Oh my god. Thank you for the 25 months, dude. Isn't Lauti Austrian? No, he's definitely Dutch. He's very Dutch. He's very Dutch. Easy call if he shoves. Gonna be a 7 big blind shove. We already have 2 invested. As you can see, we only have to call 5 big blinds. I'll take a 9 to lock it down. It's a flush. Too bad. Look good for a second. If he 3-bets a fold, if he folds, I'm gonna 3-bet fold. I know, why did you want to win? Haha, Reimer, thank you for the $2. exciting. Pretty exciting, every pot. Alright, so 147 people are left. It just keeps counting down, like, we'll see what happens. Definitely not too much, too many ICM implications. About as tough a table as you're gonna get this this tournament, to be honest. About as tough as you're gonna get, but this is gonna be a battle, man. It's the World Fucking Championships. Alright, I'm gonna raise. If Eric shows on the big blind, we have a calling hand. If he 3-bets, we call. Those are our options here. Oh, you car, I think it's 500 bits. That's funny. Oh, man, that's funny. Alright, so now it's a little bit different. If he shows, I'm just gonna fold. Well Shines, thank you for the sub. Killshot's not on the thing. Casino Daddy, oh my god. He has sent 2,000 people. Guys, please check Casino Daddy out sometime. You guys are awesome, man. It's the second big host you guys dropped me. Showed him some love. Thank you so much, everybody. Welcome. Everybody fucking welcome from Casino Daddy's stream. We're playing the World Championship of Online Poker. And we are last 142. First place is 1.5 million. Every moment's going to be streamed live. Enjoy the show. Yo, hockey, that's a bad card. Hockey fan, thank you so much for the 768. Let's hope we call with King 10 and then we're going to feel good on this river. Thank you so much, hockey fan. Ah, not bad. Not bad. Not bad. Yo, guys, that puts us on a viewer record. 19,769 viewers. We got a record, boys and girls. Sub records, viewer records. Let's make the biggest fucking win on Twitch ever. Euphoria, thank you for the sub. Buncho Sonder, thank you for the sub. So we have 50 big blinds. Blinds are going up steadily and nicely paced. Rising, thank you for the sub, get the arrow. Now this is a flop. I'm gonna bet half pot, I think, or a little under, but I think it's kind of nice, the best bet sizing. We could have like a one-off bullet to bet. Also, it fits really well with his check raising stack, right? If he has 7x, he might just think, ah, oh, fuck it, or a weaker 10x, or let's say, like, you know, king 9 with the king of spades, all that stuff could just check raise it in here. Oh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. It's gonna bet small, we don't really have anything to fear. We could barrel this small as well. Rising, take with a tier 2 sub gift to Poker Trash, that's so nice of you. We beat so many hands now, oh my god. I'm gonna show for value here. That's pretty disgusting, not gonna lie. That's a pretty disgusting hand there, right there. Wow, that is a nasty fucking cooler. Holy shit, look at his boards. If the turn is not an ace, you know, I'm betting the turn, checking the river. This is so disgusting, holy fuck. Alright, so that's pretty gross. Definitely have to value betting hands here, but... Oi, oi, oi. Alright. That's a big loss. That's a big loss. We got 30 big blinds left though. Plenty to work with, but it's a big loss. Oh man, that was fucking sweetest board ever. I think he felt the same. Alright. Alright, thank you, thank you. Let's get a chance to make this up. Eretz 13, thank you for subbing. This will be a bad time to shove, Eric. Oh my god, let's do it, guys. Fucking get the stack back up to 4 milli. Ace is all in, it doesn't get better than this. Yeah, we're running, alright. Is he thinking about it? No. No, 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 no. No, shut the fuck up, like. Shut the fuck up. We're not. You just gotta be fucking kidding me right now, like.
I love my job.
This is, alright. We have chips left, so I'm not gonna fucking pretend like we're out, but. It's hard to not feel like a deja vu. Thank you so much for the sub. Okay, so I am having a little bit of flashbacks to what's been happening deep in tournaments, which is why we're downswinging so hard. This hand, okay. And then you get into this spot. Pretty much the dream scenario. You get aces, you get shoved on. 15 big blind stack, 16 big blinds. Big stack goes all in, and you're up with aces against aces. Okay, could still improve, you know, could still win this money, go back to 3 million, lose against Queen 10. Oy, 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 oy. If it doesn't have aces, we just make a milli. We keep our stack, right? We keep our stack, but then we get 2 million from the side pile, but he has aces as well. Wow, it's just, wow. All right, we passed 20,000 viewers for the first time. That is actually, that has to put a smile on my face. Never seen that number in the stream. That's fucking awesome. We got nines. This is it. We gotta do it. We gotta do it with nines. Super strong hand. Would be great if he shoves, but very easy to go all in. Here we go. Look. Alright, we got a fighting chance, boys. We got a fighting chance. Micro cuts, thank you so much for 1500 bits. Check river. Oh, you guys haven't. Alright, guys. Alright. This is a really bad flop. You don't really want to see about these kind of board textures against big blinds. I'm gonna check it. The queen jack hand kind of plays into our favor now. Not basher, thank you for the sub. I'll take a 9. A 9 is gonna get bluffed a lot. A 9 much more so than an ace. Alright. Nice. All right, we got 30 big blinds. We got what we started with. So guys, we just started playing the main event 5K. Day 2 has been underway for a little over an hour. And we were able to chip up 400,000 chips despite the blinds coming down by a lot. We made 2 money jumps. Good stuff. Yeah, there's multiple signals to those two hands. The ace 10 is a very easy value bet on the river, guys. There's 2 pairs in his range. There's ace X, like let's say ace jack with a spade, ace 8 with a spade. There's ace highs that might hero call us. There's all kinds of rivers, king 10. There's all kinds of hands that can hero call us. Also, if we have a missed flush draw, we're gonna show. So, kind of crazy, huh? I mean, aces against aces is already pretty tilting, but then to lose the queen 10, that's the kind of stuff when you see on TV that gets replayed. Oh my god, did you see that sick fucking hand? That's the kind of stuff. This kind of reminds me, somebody said on a forum, a friend of mine said, why does the average, like, recreational, why are they so tight these days? Why do they always think everything is a fold or a check? And you see it, like, in Twitch chat all the time. People just think everything is a check and a fold. I think honestly think that people should bluff more and call lighter and everything. It's so crazy. It's like pretty standard value bets, you know? So, can't really say anything else about it. We got nines again. If Markovic shoves, I'm calling. If he raises, I'm shoving. If he raises, I'm shoving. If he shoves, I call. If he raises, I'm shoving. Pretty easy. Pretty easy to play this one. Alright, good luck us. Alright. 2800. I can't handle the swings. It's kind of crazy. Yeah, it's a true main event that we're running here. Ups, downs, highs, lows. All right, so 123 people left. That means 16 spots. The money will go up with $5,000. We are all right. We are in 76 out of 123. Again, you see the people slowly are getting more deep, but it's still a pretty quick tournament. I like that. All right, kings. This is our Achilles heel. This is our Achilles heel this year, kings. Definitely this Wcoop. Very glad to see them though, don't get me wrong. Thank you, Snurfer. Thank you, Oklaye, for the subs. I swear to God, 80% of chat's relieved right now that he folded. 80% of the chat's relieved right now. Oh, they don't think they're gonna make things easy for you yet. No, not yet, but we'll see. It's the world fucking championship, man. You can call yourself the world champion of online poker once you win this event. This has been the most fucking prestigious event ever since its origin online. Origin, you know? All right, 90,000. In 2 minutes, the blinds will be up to 500. 50. In 2 minutes, the blinds will go up to 50,000, 100,000. Very small jump. We'll still have 30 big blinds ish. Like in this spot, same thing. If I have a lot of chips, wow, what a flop. If you check raise, I'm just gonna get it in. I feel like for the same reasons, he's gonna check raise quite a bit because of the money coming. This is a board people like to check raise, so there you go. So we raise this, we're just gonna shove this. Yo, hold it. Thank you for the sub, Rizzy. Thank you for the 13 months. Yes! 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 Alright. 6 million. Alright, 6 million. We got 60 bigs. Everybody calm the fuck down. Short-term loan. Stuff I can eat with the shots fired. All right. Sasha, 2801. Thank you so much for solving. Oh, feels good. Oh, that ace on the turn, fucking liberating. When it's like the 10 on the turn, you're like... Rrr! Kings, fold. Here we go. Oh, shit. You see the chat? Everybody knows. Oh, my God. We lost so many sick ones. We had one day, and this is seriously not to whine. I just want to explain the chat reaction. We had one day. We busted four highs this Wcoop with kings versus aces. Four highs. Pretty easy fold if Lasagna Man had 3 bets here. Ace 6 is just such a fucking tragic hand. Let's make him sweat a little bit. He knows it's gonna be a fold as soon as, like, I'm not gonna solve him. Like, I don't really, like, you know, my ranges are pretty set. I know what I have to call with when I open, so... Like, raising and then going, that almost never happens, right? Same when people 3-bet and somebody goes all in. When people tank, it's like, what are you thinking about? Like, you know, you need to 3-bet with a plan to open this. If, like, everybody's hovering around 3 or there's, like, 1-5 million and a few 2 million stacks, I'm definitely raising this with the money bubble in mind. So, as we see, the play slows down again, too. This 12-bit blind, this spot gets 5k more. That's the buy-in of the event, and it's 5k, so... All right, move tables. What's it gonna look like? This actually looks better. Gavs is really active. He's really good. Assad, I don't know, but this looks much better. Wow, this is a relief from the table we just played. We also have position on a guy with 13 million. So maybe we could play some interesting pass here. There's gonna be button against my big blind. So we have queens. Okay, that's kind of sick. We have Queens, it's still on the money bubble. Here we go. Yo, holy shit, nice dude. Dylan Zombie King, thank you for the massive support yesterday. That was sick, dude. Thank you for the $5 again. Nice for you, dudes. Alkaline Yum, thank you for subbing. Alright, so this is kind of a sick thing. Yes, we're on that bubble. But no, we're also not gonna fold Queens, so. Let's raise. And if he shows, we're gonna call, so. We have a super strong hand. People can maybe fuck around with us. He has a stack to fuck around with us if he so chooses. Can't think about the bubbles. We still, it's the third best hand in poker. We still just gotta play it. Thank you, Shot by 3333. Much appreciated. Ernie 4 with a sub. Okay. I'm not very indifferent. Very fine. Very fine that we didn't get too much action there. Very easy button raise there. Money bubble burst. Important to know, that means that we can't 3-bet this guy. Normally I could 3-bet this guy, but the money bubble did burst. So we make 22,000 regardless now. What's the next one, you guys ask? The next bubble is going to be 6,000 more if 36 people bust. So we're just going to keep looking one step ahead at a time. I'm going to 3-bet fold this. That is not million, right? Okay. We're going to 3-bet fold this. Against the regular, I don't think that I can call it profitably. But it blocks ace-king, ace-queen, aces and jacks. Alright, there we go. So against a recreational, I might be very more tempted to play it out. Also because the recreational is going to bluff less. They're going to not value bet as hard. So there's all like these little scenarios that will work out for me better. Whereas against the regular, I know that I can make him fold stuff that has very good odds against me. Plus, if we go to a flop, let's say he has a hand like Queen Jack that I dominate, right? And the flop comes King 9 4, then he wins the pot. Or it comes 6-5-3, he bets, he wins the pot. So, kind of want to avoid that. This is a good flop. Asian Husky and Coxsor and Psychonaut. Thank you for the subs. Yo, Purple Pills, what's up, dude? Thank you for the sub. Soda, I think it was so. P Money Crush as well. Wow, your subs are rolling in. Thank you guys so much. So I don't think I don't expect to get check raised by hands like King Queen, King Nine, you know. That sort of thing. I don't think straights for that reason. I would say straights is the only thing. See, this hand I think is much more light to value about this than the ace 10. Alright. Also because I don't expect him to call with hands like King 7, but we win a chunk of chips there, so I'm happy with it. I think this check, like this hand is way more marginal than the ace 10 for instance, so. Which poker viewer record? Not yet. I think that Jason Somerville and Jason Mercier had 27,000 something viewers when they were watching when they were playing the 100k of the Wcoop a few years ago. That's a viewer record for an online tournament. So I need to get above that if I ever want to be the highest like that plays an online tournament. And then there's also some like big events that got like live events that got a little more viewers, but. Also, one step at a time. We're just gonna see, enjoy the ride. Not gonna focus too much on that. Quality, always better. Man, the poker community is really, 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 really going a long way. It's really fucking awesome seeing everything come together. The amount of people that we had streamed during Wcoop is so cool. So much variety, so many different styles, so many different channels. It's unreal. It's so awesome. It's so awesome. I'm gonna be at Run of the Brino too, at the 19th of October till the 25th of October. The event will run till the 29th. They have poker tournaments, $100 tournaments, they have small cash games, they have a $600 main event, a 1k thrill, you know, all that stuff. It's gonna be pretty much like the Twitch poker conference right there. So if you wanna meet us, all the streamers are gonna be there too. Jeff Gross, Jamie Staples, Matt Staples, Finton, Spraggy, everybody that you know and love is gonna be there. And yeah, it's like a big home game. So definitely check that out, man. Like, poker's going a good way, and I think that that's a really cool set piece in the poker industry right now. Gonna defend this. Yeah, Linus does have a great avatar. If you're playing a heads up against somebody with a Pokemon avatar with 40 or 100k stacks. Good flop. We're gonna check all the turn. He's gonna try and represent the king quite a bit. The good thing is that if I have a really strong hand here, I'm check calling the turn, check raising the river. So that gives me a little bit of comfort that he might check for some bluffs. It's really hard for us to have nothing right now. Alright, so he's gonna fold. Pretty easy by then. Pretty bad run out. Good flop, good start to the hand, but... Oh, he joined Liv's table. That's very useful. Let's see. Let's watch Senpai as well. Senpai is only a few spots below me, I feel. Where the fuck are you, Ben? Did you win a pot? Oh, please don't tell me you're out. Uh-oh. Where is he? Jesus. Ah, he's on our table. There you are. Alright, we got King Queen suited, it's a pretty good hand. 77 people left, so 6k money jump in 5 spots. Very interesting. We're gonna flat call here. We know that he opens hands like Queen 10 from that position. Would love to keep those hands in. Saw that Queen 10 earlier, which is nice. I would not have noticed that if I played only one table, you know. If we get shoved on, we're probably gonna have to call. I'm not gonna be super stoked about it, but with the money invested, the dead money in the pot, and the fact that he has 16, 17 big blinds, we have to call. Jacks, 10s, 9s, 8s are all gonna go all in, you know what I mean? So, all right, got a little piece, but gotta be careful. Yo, thank you, Sean, for the $3. Much appreciated, buddy. Myers Wu, thank you for the 1,000 bits. As usual, very generous. Black DMND, thank you for the 5 months and the skunk number. Thank you for the sub. I saw a skunk on the night we walked around, the first night we got back from Japan. I saw a skunk outside here. Never seen one before. So, he bets pretty big. Now, this is nice for multiple reasons, because if we call, it's going to be pretty scary for him, and it's going to be very hard to bluff rivers. So... it feels like we're pretty protected. Now, the heart is not a great card, but maybe he puts us on hearts and checks King Jack. You know, you never know how it works out. If he bets here, I'm gonna assume that it's a bad card for us. But there's plenty of chances for us to just check this down and win. Yo, Cooler, thank you so much for the host, man. All right, now we have an easy fold. Gonna think about it a little bit. That's so nice. I really love, like, fucking hosts. Check out Cooler sometimes, guys. He's a first-person shooter player. Quick champions. My chat has been meaning to let me try and play that. I really hope you had a good session, and really cool that you brought all your peoples here. So I'm going to have to bet big here because from the small blind, because I'm out of position. He's going to defend a lot, and it's just kind of the new meta game to raise big. Also, when somebody limps the big blind, you raise a 3.5 from the big blind itself. Gambler 340, thank you for the sub. Bensi be in a really tough spot here. People tend to just call with a lot of draws. Oh my god. Bensi B's out. God damn, that sucks. tension. Message from Pokestar support. Lexi Terminator, how have you grown that beaker army? Keep crushing Veld Love. Oh, and fuck you, less than three. How fucking awesome is that, man? Fucking Stars gets it, man. That's incredible. All right, let's replay this hand. The rip of NCB. So this was called pre-flop three-way. Bet, call. And this is a very interesting line that we've seen a lot more often now. And he leads the turn. So he doesn't want this guy to check back King Jack, to be able to check back Ace Jack, all of that stuff. You know, spade draws, flush draws. He wants to tax them, and the guy shoves. And Ben in the tank and thinks that the guy has a flush draw. Calls it off. Not good. Very tough. I really love this. Is a new meta thing. I really love the check call flop lead turn. We've seen Giraffe Ganger do it a bit, plenty of times. Too bad though that it results in the death of Master. Alright, and that puts us with three people left to bust for 6k money jump. Jax. That would be an amazing hand. We have 30 something big blinds. We're gonna play for stacks. I think unless he raises. If he raises, we'll flat. If he raises easy all in, if he raises easy 3-bet, then we're gonna call it off. And if anything else happens, we're gonna open. And if they 3-bet us, we're gonna be all in. So lots of action could happen here. I'm not gonna step away from a fight here. We have to realize that we're playing for the World Championship here, and we're not playing just the ladder, you know. There's like ICM, that I'm saying it like that because ICM is very important. It's very important to play tight near the money and whatever, and make folds. But there's a limit. There's a limit to where it's way more important to start winning chips again because your hand is so strong or you have such a big advantage. This would be one of those limits. This would be one of those limits. So we're just gonna 3-bet this guy to like a million, call it off. If this guy shoves, we're gonna go over the top. Make this a million. Honestly, if this guy shoves, I would fold because we're not gonna be able to be exploitable here. We're 3-betting a guy that's short on a bubble as a reasonable short stack ourselves. So it's like, you know, pretty strong. All right, it's good to see some chippies. Would you say final three you chop this tournament? I would chop earlier than that. I wouldn't have a problem with that. Chopping has nothing to do with like not giving a fuck, you know. It is, but I mean, if you have like really good players, and like look at this, like if you're third, you're guaranteed 700. You can win 800,000 more if you finish two spots higher in a tournament where 2,044 people played. You know, that's too sick, man. That's too sick. You're never gonna get to this spot again, right? You like, it's so unlikely that you get to a spot where you're gonna be playing online again for 1.5 million. Like, the variance of that is so insane, man. If somebody would, like, let's say, let's chop it up according to chip stacks or the value of your stack, you know, whatever, and play for 100,000, I'm down. But I'm not gonna let somebody eat the fucking shit from my bread and say, I want more. No. No. Strap yourselves in, because we're gonna be counting stacks. That's what we'll be doing then. Yo, RW Tiv, thank you for the sub. I get lost in the bathroom. I have that some Saturday nights. Now I feel interesting. Jax. Probably very highly ranked in the hands that you guys hate the most. Ski Man and NM Cannonball, thank you for the brand new subs. 200k Bench, thank you for the 20 months, big boy, one of my first viewers, thank you so much. Alright, so Liv got third in the hand. Very nice, very nice. Let's look at the... Oh, 71! Alright, so we laddered. And it's not just a ladder, guys. It's a... Now this guy goes out. So now you're gonna have like the stack shuffle. This is a big ladder, guys. We are guaranteed $28,600 right now. Pretty fucking nice. And now we get an end where we can just go for. We're gonna start with a raise here. See what happens. We have 30 bigs. Almost exactly. Thank you, dude. Chris, got that. Thank you for the $3. If he shows a very easy call, he's gonna shove ace jack suited, ace ten suited, ace queen offsuit or suited. The lower pairs, obviously we don't like to see those, but mix in the other ones and we're gonna be very happily calling here. So this is Dominic Nietzsche joining the table. He defends his big blinds probably as much as anybody else. Thank you so much, Saku. Yeah, that's crazy when you look at it that way. So I know he's gonna check raise me quite a bit off my hand, or try and check raise me off my hand, but I still want to see bet because I know that he defends king 4, king 3, all that stuff. He is gonna check raise quite frequently though, so I'm gonna float him. I already know this. Like, I know that he defends super wide. I know that he's gonna check raise me. I know that I'm gonna have to call, but I also know that he's gonna give up a lot. Like, he's still gonna fold a lot of king 8s and stuff like that, you know. So we're just gonna call here, see what happens. And obviously we're also calling because we have a backdoor flush draw. Another Broadway card is pretty good for us. I'm just gonna bet small here. He's also gonna check raise some fives and deuce x. I'm betting to get him off those hands. It makes sense for my stack if I bet this size as well. So I just have to make this move, otherwise this guy is gonna snow me under out of position and I don't feel like that happening. So, and if he shoves, he shoves, he has it, but I feel like there's gonna be plenty of check folds in here. It's nice that we can bet small. It makes sense from a stack to pot ratio. We leave a good bet for the river. It also, like, we're not super deep. I'm not scared. All right, it's a world championship poker. You gotta beat guys like Dominic Nietzsche. That's what you gotta do. All right, Marky, thank you for the sub. Rato, thank you for the resub. All right then. Stock on Friday, I shipped a 1650 freeze up for 1.2k and decided to take a shot in the mini main, which I cashed for 1.2k as well. Oh my god, nice. Congrats. Thank you for the 555. Awesome. Anonymous, thank you for the $2 and the super weird donation. Not gonna call. 22 big blinds all in here. It's way too tight. Way too light. Linus Love has 40 million in chips, ladies and gentlemen. And he takes him out. Can't imagine just playing the Bosque or Baby Metal right now. Alright, we're gonna 3-bet bluff here. Okay. Thank you so much, Minhoffs, for that and the 333. Thank you, Yop, for the 2 and CWCTL2. Thank you for 5 months. So, this is a bluff. Obviously, don't want to flat. Too many good players behind me as well. I think we have a lot of full equity. Nice, so sweet though. So sweet when it works, you know. All right, live is all in. She needs an ace or a jack. Oof, that's rough. GG, Olivia. God damn, that's too bad. That's too bad. So Liv is out for $28,000. Plus in 60 seconds. Too bad. So let's do a roundup of what we're doing right now. We're guaranteed $28,000. $28,000. If we make it to 44th place, which is 16 spots away, we ladder. $8,000 more. Not bad, not bad. I feel like every time we ladder now, we make up for a day of Wcoop that we lost. It's kind of, because we've spent about $8,000 in buy-ins every day, so it kind of feels nice. 36,000, but 16 people need to bust. That's a lot. That's a fourth of the field, so even this guy has 25 big blinds, and there we go. We're off. Alright. One second, guys. This is crazy. I'm gonna check. I really, really, really fucking hope there's not gonna be a spade on the river. I really, really fucking hope we don't see a spade on the river. It could be a small disaster. I just talked to Ben CB about the hand that he played against him. Oh, everything about me tells me that this is bad news. It's really not a great runout to bluff. I mean, flush gets are true, but... Take it. Take it. Take it, take it. So we got 27 big blinds now. Oh, ace king. Holy shit. Let's go. We can just shove from the big blind. Let's fucking do this. Wow, we got a monster. That's nice. That's nice. Duke Wilson, thank you for the 333 bits. And P Boozer, Official Rick, and Atsuki, thank you for the subs. Alright, let's do it, bud. He's gonna limb raise a lot of weaker aces, which would be fucking marvelous here, of course. If he has a hand like ace 5, he's just gonna shove them now. There you go, come on. Queen 9. Please. No. No, not this way. Not this way. Not after that flop, come on. Oh, that stings a little. That stings a little. You know what the problem is? I realized that, like, before the flop, he has 38%. Like, plan worked exactly, right? Like, we make it a little bit bigger, everything works. This is what hurts. 92%. So out of... when we see this flop, we know that out of 100 times, 92.5 times, we're gonna win this pot. And then this one gets you worried, and this one is a dagger in your heart. This really hurts. This really hurts. We got so deep. We got so far. Oh, yeah, yeah. It hurts, man. I'm just, like, thinking about it. Like, that's... we had 9 million. 9 million pot gets us right up there. Right where we want to be. Right where we want to be. Fuck, that's crazy, dudes. Boys and girls, this is poker pain right there. Oh, my God. This is undeserved. Oh my god, I realized we have another, like, top 60, 60, 40 in a big event. I mean, at least we won 28,000, that's nice. That's nice. It's a band-aid. Doesn't quite cover the pain that we've suffered through, but it definitely is a big help. Holy shit. I don't really know what to say. This is like, it hits me like a hammer. It's tough. I really enjoyed the run. You know, like, it just feels like we're just fall kind of short again. I mean, obviously, like, super hyped. Super grateful about everything, but it's a tough ending. It's a tough ending. Blind versus blind, he just gets there. God damn it! You can play it back as many times as you want, but look at this shit. Like I had to keep myself seated. I had to keep myself on my seat to say to myself, it's not over yet, even though we could just jump up and celebrate. You know, and that's like, that says enough. Like, the fact that the worry is in your head means you're not, you know, not from a... Not had a great period, but fuck, man, it's a pretty sick run. Jesus, 28k though, that's a pretty big fucking cash. 7603 players, 33,000 viewers, unbelievable. Oh man, it stings a little, but I feel pretty good. Like, I feel pretty good. We fucking smashed records today. Fuck, I'm kind of waiting till you guys see it too. Yeah. There you go. I'm just like silent, like I'm fucking in mourning of my stack. Always the same fucking fingers sound like the last week, so you can be proud, decision around points. Man, it really is. Like fucking these, like whenever we play all the post-flop spots, I'm so sure of what I'm doing and that it's right. And that's good. That is actually one of the things that makes me just want to compete more and more. Because I really feel like, you know, the one thing that I don't have under my control, if we win all-ins deep in tournaments, if that's the thing, then, you know, we're gonna be fine.